Pankaj. Today we will talk about mucogingival surgery. So before we talk about it, let's see how the history has come. The term mucogingival was initially described by Friedman to describe the surgical procedures for correction relationship between gingiva and mucosa. Mucogingival, mucosa and gingiva, which includes initially only included attached gingiva corrections, shallow vestibules, frenum interfering with marginal gingiva. Now, in 1996, a workshop was done and that has accepted calling it as periodontal plastic surgery, because we no more deal with only these three things. We do all the above procedures in this periodontal plastic surgery, which was originally when it was proposed by Miller. Periodontal plastic surgery, understanding the terms is most important, because the bits will be given in that way. If they are telling you periodontal plastic surgery, that means it includes correction or elimination of anatomic, developmental, traumatic deformities of gingiva or alveolar mucosa. Mucogingival therapy is a big broad term which includes all that. Reconstruction of papilla through ortho is also mucogingival therapy. But periodontal plastic surgery means only the surgical procedures. Okay. Now, they have mainly five objectives. Number one, attached gingiva, shallow vestibule, aberrant frenum, aesthetic surgical therapy and tissue engineering. So coming to how you treat it. So first of all, gingiva augmentation apical to area of recession means increasing the width of attached gingiva. When you do this, this procedure is called mostly perioplastic surgeries, because nothing to aesthetics is here. But when you take something coronal to the recession, root coverage, this is more a aesthetic surgery. Moving on to the next, you see these various list of techniques used for gingival augmentation, like that coronal to the recession means root coverage, free gingival graft, connective tissue graft, pedicel graft, laterally positioned, coronally positioned, subepithelial, GTR pouch. So I will tell you how briefly you remember. So nothing. It is basically based on the donor site. You take rough image of how you have the layers. This is epithelium. This is connective tissue. Okay. So when you take this free gingival autograft, you are taking this only part of gingiva and transferring it to the donor site. When it is free connective tissue autograft, you are taking only connective tissue. That means epithelium is left behind, periosteum is left, only connective tissue is transferred to the site. Pedicel graft means pedicel, it is pedicellated. For example, it is like this. Only thing is it has a pedicel. Lateral means it will move laterally. Coronally means it will try to move front coronally. However, it will move according to the direction. That is according to how they move, it is called as coronally you are moving. It is a coronally positioned flap. Now, subepithelial connective tissue flap means it is like little different when compared to connective tissue. But mostly, yes, in only thing where it differs is the way you place it back in the recipient site. Coming to GTR and pouch and tunnel techniques are little latest techniques. Just remember the names. So this is how you do a pedicel flap. Here from you have removed, twisted, placed it. This also will have a gingiva, this also will have it now. So this is our free gingival graft. There is no width of attached gingiva at all. But at the end of the procedure, see how beautiful width of attached gingiva the people has got. Moving on. See, they are variant techniques now. Because it is so, actually if you see this kind of flap, it is so difficult to get this side of the flap, okay. So the graft. So you have various techniques, accordion, strip, and the combination of epithelial connective tissue strip technique. Moving on to the accordion, it is just that you make some striations on the graft to extend it. Strips are the graft is cut into small pieces and placed on the side, and there's a combination technique. This is a coronally advanced flap to cover this part. So you have a thick gingiva, thick attached gingiva, cut, it is little ahead, placed coronally and suturing is done. That's how it's a, and you can see there is no more recession or concavity seen. Here there can be a synthetic substitutes like that of alloderm, GTR, so that you don't have to harvest. If you need more structure, you cannot harvest, right? So you will buy something, and here we are intending to both increase the width of attachment as well as root coverage. Mainly you have done a beautiful root coverage, and you can see the pre and post operative images. So this is a subepithelial connective tissue graft I was telling you, where you take a graft, you have split. I told you it is split. You are not cutting the bone, going, removing it like this, putting the graft here and suturing back. This is subepithelial connective tissue technique. And finally, we also learned there is a aberrant frenal procedures which we do. So frenectomy and frenotomy, this is how, because if this is there, you see there is a recession, progressive recession happening. So this pressure has to be reduced. That is the reason why you do a frenectomy. And once the frenectomy is done, see how good attached gingiva and healthy, which patient can maintain for a long period of time. So this is more about mucogingival procedures. There's some criteria for the selection. Not on every case you can do. First and foremost is free of plaque, calculus and inflammation, because it is an aesthetic procedure. You should not have infection there. Adequate blood supply for the donor tissue. Adequate for the recipient tissue. Stability of the graft has to be there for it to integrate. Minimal trauma. All these are beautiful criteria. Make a note of all of them. Okay. Thank you all.